Hi, I'm Marysa Prettyman.
And I'm Lee Prettyman. I'm Marysa's father. I grew up in a church, but by the time I got to high school and turned 18 and got out of high school, I didn't want to go to church anymore. Fast forward a few years, and I met Vicky, my wife. She was a Christian, but I was not. I was kind of going through the motions really at that time. We started having kids, and by the time the kids got old enough, she encouraged us to go to church. Went to a church in Tecumseh for several years. I'll be totally transparent. The sign on the billboard said service from 11 to 12 p.m. and I started getting fed up because the pastor was talking to 1210 almost every day. And at one point, I told Vicky that if he goes past 12 one more time, we're going to go look for another church. And he went to 1215, and we started looking for another church. I saw a billboard that said, IHateMyMarriage.org, which I thought was kind of interesting. Who would post something like that on a billboard? So I looked at the website and found out that it was the website for Crossroads. We checked it out. I loved the music. Heard a message that I could connect with and related to, and I could apply the very next day. And I thought, okay, this church might work out. Again, I was still going through the motions, but it was something that I could put up with for, believe it or not, 65 minutes. When we were walking to our car, Marysa said, "That was fun. Can we come back here again next week?" Message after message, connecting with people, I eventually gave my life to Christ. I wanted to be in control of everything, but then when I gave it all to God and said, "You take the wheel and you control it," there was a sense of relief to me and an enthusiasm that I never had before.
Small group has probably been one of my favorite parts, just hanging out with different kids from different schools.
And even though Crossroads is a big church, you can experience community and life with people by getting connected in serving teams and in a small group. Small groups became very important to us, to our family. Our youngest, Benjamin, got sick, and number one, what I would have done in that situation had I not first and foremost had a relationship with Jesus. Leaning on Him is just, I don't know how I'd do it without Him. Having a staff that cared about us so much, a small group that cared about us so much, that when Ben got sick and got life-flighted to Toledo, they all showed up. They spent the night with us in the waiting room at the hospital, with us through that whole
2 weeks
event, 10 days, yes. And we prayed for God to perform a miracle, but if you couldn't perform a miracle and keep Him here with us, Ben had a forever friend in Jesus, and that we knew when he was done here that he would go to heaven. Without that relationship, without those people in my life, in our lives, I don't know how I would continue to move forward every day. The other exciting thing that I'm pleased with and just blessed, really, that neither Raymond or Marysa did the same thing that I did when they turned 18 and moved out of the house or on to college. They haven't walked away.
I go to Siena, as most people know, and I'm a sophomore there going for special education and elementary education. But I just remember going into Kid Crossing with my brothers and seeing people from school or just new people that I had never met before, and just learning about how Jesus is my best friend or wants to be my best friend and will love me and care for me and just always be there when nobody else will. I remember Kid Fusion. It was just really fun coming up with dance moves and singing songs that I loved. And I remember bringing in like invites sometimes to school and like leaving them on my like classmates' chairs and stuff for Kid Fusion when it was at Adrian High School. I wouldn't have some of the friends that I have today. Without Kid Crossing, just meet other families through pre-K and the toddler program. Melanie was able to allow me to keep the same like 8-10 students from the time they were 3 years old, and I worked with them until they were second or third graders, and now one of them, she's like my little sister. It's just been awesome to share the same virtues and verses and songs and things like that that were shared with me when I was growing up, and now I was able to give back a little bit of my time there. Now this college group is really cool. I have another group of friends, another support group, another group of people that a majority of them are believers, and it's just a safe place. And you can struggle with them, celebrate with them, and just do life. Leading and planning those groups, if you would have told me when I was 13 years old that I would be sitting here right now, or told me that I was at Siena leading a Bible study group, I didn't even want to pray at accelerate like group time, because I didn't want to. That was somebody else's job. Knowing that like when I come home there will be those memories, but also like being able to share like why I believe in God and Jesus and why I am who I am today. It's a lot easier to overestimate like, okay, oh, you're a Christian, like I don't want to talk to you because of this and this reason. But I've learned, especially this year, stepping out of my comfort zone, just being real with people, not being afraid to take risks, going up to somebody and asking them, like, hey, who are you again? Like, I heard your name is so-and-so, like, where are you from? How are you doing? And friendships can just build.